High sea traffic potentially becomes the source of unintentional oil spill in Indonesia. Some oil spill cases happened in the north and south of Java Sea, also in Malacca and Makassar Strait. Based on Verdi data 2018, the causes of oil spill accidents are: the fitting leak, boiler leak, leak offsite, feed line leak, oil tank leak, fire, storm damage, and other common during operations when oil is being loaded or discharged. Negative impacts of oil spill affect not only the environment but also human life, from social, health, and economic aspects. One of the worst environmental disasters in Indonesia, caused by an oil spill incident, has polluted Balikpapan Bay in 2018. It began with the burst of the subsea pipeline on 31st of March. This pipe was normally used to distribute crude oil from Lawa-Lawa Terminal in North Pinajam to Pertamina Refinery Unit facility in Balikpapan. The officials claimed that an anchor of a bulk carrier got stuck and dragged the oil pipe in the seabed until it bends and broke. The spill eventually caught fire and indirectly killed five fishermen. This oil spill accident absolutely threatened the livelihoods of many and ravaged the surrounding environment. Indonesia government include CMMAI, Pertamina, Ministry of Environment and Forestry, Ministry of Marine Affairs and Fisheries, Ministry of Indonesian State-Owned Enterprise, East Borneo Local Government, and Ministry of Transportation has been actively investigated this incident. This accident task force, coordinated by Indonesian Ministry of Transportation, Pertamina, and local agencies, aimed at curbing the spreading of the spill. In this case, one of the obstacles to the emergency response process was incomplete information and data obtained from the field during the first hour after the oil spill accident. It is also known that the onset of the incident took place at night, when the direct visual observation was very limited. And, when using satellite imagery observation, it really depends on the satellite's position and coverage when an incident occurs. However, this moment is a critical period for the task force when making decisions about emergency response plans. Based on the Presidential Regulation Republic of Indonesia, a response plan for oil spill emergencies is a fast, precise, and coordinated action to prevent and overcome the spread of oil spills and mitigate the environmental impacts to minimize public losses and damage to the marine environment. When referring to an international oil spill contingency plan, the plan includes the oil spill movement prediction, methods and techniques of countermeasures, calculation of personnel requirements, the amount of oil spill response equipment, and trajectory modeling. The use of model results as part of the emergency response plan has been implemented by NOAA's Office of Response and Restoration since 3 decades ago in the Exxon Valdez oil spill incident that contaminated Prince William Sound, Alaska. In this case, the results of the model are used to predict the oil spill movement and give preliminary information about the impact in the initial stage. This research predicted the movement of the oil spill with a high temporal resolution, with output per hour. This study also distinguishes the ability of the oil spill model to calculate the change in mass of the oil spills due to the weathering process from the beginning of the incident to a specific time when oil remains in the sea. In order to predict the trajectory and the fate of the oil, this study uses the open oil model. The model's input data uses hourly current velocity, and it's generated from the ROMS ocean model. Meanwhile, wind speed data uses a global dataset from the European Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasts, ECMWF ERA5, that has been subsetted according to the domain model of Balikpapan Bay with 1 hour period. To validate the model output, then the elevation data from the hydrodynamic model are compared to the tides observation of the Indonesian Geospatial Information Agency database at Smayang Port, Balikpapan. Root mean squared error, mean absolute percentage error, and model skill are used as verification methods, where the results for each method are 8.8 centimeters, 9.5%, and 0.9. Which shows the simulation results from the ocean model is in good agreement with the observational data. Meanwhile, because there is no observation data of the oil spills, the verification is carried out by visually comparing the oil spill distribution pattern from the open oil model results and satellite image at the same time period. To be able to get the output in a short time, a high-performance computing system that can solve the complex numerical equations much quicker than the ordinary computer is used, which is provided by the server of MTCRC. In real events, server utilization becomes an essential part of the operational oil spill modeling to support the task force team in responding to the incident of the oil spill. From the other research result, it also can be seen that the oil spill spread rapidly by the time passing. This statement also confirmed by the National Institute of Aeronautics and Space of Indonesia, based on satellite image data on March 31, 2018, which shows that almost the entire Balikpapan Bay and some of the parts of Makassar Strait has been contaminated by the oil spill. During the leaking of crude oil from the pipe, it is seen that oil is rising to the surface due to the difference in density between oil and seawater, and once on the surface, the oil will spread and carried away by the currents in the Balikpapan Bay. The currents in this bay are dominated by tidal influences, so it also can be seen that the spreading of oil are affected by the tidal currents in Balikpapan Bay, which the maximum extents occurs during ebb or flood tide. From about 40,000 barrels of oil that were spilled in 12 hours, it was found that the oil particles, which had a mass percentage of 100%, had been halved in less than a day. This is closely related to the oil weathering that can naturally remove the oil that already released into the water by physical, chemical, and biological processes. In addition, some of these oil spills also washed up and stranded along the coast of Balikpapan Bay, which caused most of the beaches in the Penajam and Balikpapan areas to be polluted. By using the combination of model prediction, satellite image, and direct observation in the field, it will become a good reference for the oil spill response team to work more quickly and effectively during a real incident. In conclusion, the model is good enough to predict the movement of the oil spill in Balikpapan Bay. And it is hoped that the model performances can be improved, so it would give better prediction in the future. In the end, the use of model as one of the instruments on planning the emergency oil spill response seems to have become mandatory today.